Hi, I'm Ron Seelander, Director of Engineering at eSwitch. Welcome to this third video in our six-part video on how best to choose the best switch for your application. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about pulls and throws and the top four circuits that we see mainly with all of our products. But before we get into the actual circuits, I'd like to do a little definition on what pulls and throws really are. First off, a switch really is, in its basic form, does nothing more than really open and close electrical circuits. So when the switch closes the circuit, it allows an electrical circuit to flow from point A to point B. When that happens, when we have a closed circuit in a switch, we call that a pull. Now, if you have two closed circuits at the same time, we call it a double pull. If you have three closed circuits at the same time, we call it a three pull. Four closed circuits at the same time, four pull, etc. Now, the other part of this definition is the number of throws for a switch. Now, when you look at a basic switch, for example, like on tack switches and most of our push buttons, it has to do with the position that the actuator is in. Like I said, on most tack or on all tack switches and most push button switches, you have two positions, the non-actuated position or the actuated position. On some of our rockers, you'll have either two or three positions that the actuator can be in. Most of our product will fall in between the two and three positions. We have some exceptions like dip switches, navigational switches, and even some rotary switches that you can get into, you know, six, seven, eight pull and positions. So with that definition, let's take a look at the four most unique or common types of pulls and throw circuitry that you're going to run into. The first one would be a single pull, single throw. Now, for illustration purposes, I'm going to use this on-off rocker. And if you envision that this rocker was mounted into a fan, when the fan is in the off position, the switch is in the off position, the fan's not running, as I actuate the switch, I close the circuit. So I'm running the electrical circuit, in this case, would be from your wall outlet to the motor fan on the fan. Now there is one closed circuit, hence this is a single pull device. Now getting back into the throw category, since this is an on-off switch, there is a closed circuit only in the one position, the on position. Again, that it illustrates that this is a single pull, single throw device. Now if I use the same analogy using the fan, now let's assume on this fan it has a high speed and a low speed. And to illustrate that, I'm going to take a look at this rocker, which is a three position rocker. The center position, the fan is off. As I actuate the switch to my far left, I've turned the close one circuit that goes from the wall outlet to the fan motor, and it puts the fan in a low speed. If I take and I actuate this switch to the far right, it closes one unique circuit in the switch, but it puts the fan in high mode. Now this rocker would be considered a single pull, but it is considered a double throw because I have the low speed and the high speed. The third most common circuit out there is a double pull, single throw. Now I'm going to try to represent that with this simple on-off rocker. Now let's assume this rocker is in a hairdryer. In the off position, the hairdryer is off. As I actuate the switch, I close one circuit, which would turn on the heating element inside the hairdryer. It closes a second circuit, which would turn the fan on in the hairdryer. So I have two unique closed circuits, which means this is a double pull switch. Again, since this is an on-off switch, there's only one position where those circuits are closed. Hence, again, this would be a double pull, single throw device. And the fourth most common one is a double pull, double throw switch. Again, let's assume we have the same hairdryer, but now on this hairdryer, we have a high and a low setting for this hairdryer. The switch I have right now is a three position rocker. So the center, the switch is off, the hairdryer is off. As I actuate the switch to my far right, it turns on the heating element and it closes the circuit that turns on the fan in the hairdryer in the low performance mode. As I actuate the switch all the way to my far left, it closes the circuit for the heating element in the switch or in the hairdryer, as well as it closes the circuit for the fan in the hairdryer. Now this puts that hairdryer into the high performance mode. So by definition, I'm closing two poles at the same time, hence this is a double pole switch, and I have two positions where those two circuits are closed, the low performance mode and the high performance mode. So that is why we call this a double pole, double throw device. So hopefully this clarifies up some of the misconceptions and some of the unknowns about what truly pulls and throws really mean, and can help lead you into really choosing the right device for your application. And I'd like to say, hey, subscribe to our YouTube channel so you get all of the videos in this series, as well as all of our other technical information on new products and training that we have. Also, give us this thumbs up and share all this video and information with your colleagues. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.